terminologies which we use in understanding the research philosophies. These are ontology and epistemology. Let me explain all these concepts one by one, but before that, we should understand ontology and epistemology shape your research philosophy. So the research philosophy is mainly dependent on these two components. So that's why it is important for us to understand each of these concepts. Let us start with understanding ontology. So ontology is basically answering the questions, what is reality and what shapes the reality. It tells you about the knowledge and what is happening there. Or for example, if you are planning to solve any situation or any problem, it will give you idea of that what is that problem and what are the possible solutions to that problem. Ontology gives you three basic answers. Three questions that lead to the ontology is: what is reality or knowledge? What shapes that knowledge, or what are the events that shape that knowledge or that reality? And what is the relationship between each of these components which shapes the reality or form the knowledge for you? So that is the basic of ontology. Ontology we can understand based on these three concepts. But to make it very simple, ontology is telling us about what is reality. Now there are many beliefs available for the ontology, but here to make this video very easy, I am taking only three beliefs or three major beliefs of ontology. That is, the first belief is that there is only one reality. It is called singularity. Means that there is only one universal set of solution to any problem. There is only one universal truth. There is only one reality for a specific situation or specific problem. And this reality exists without how people or how perceiver they perceive this reality. Okay, so it is called the concept of singularity. There is only one solution or one reality. Okay, now the second concept is there are more than one reality. There are many realities, and there may be possibilities, multiple realities or multiple truths are there. That is not independent of perceiver. It depends on how people they perceive the truth or the reality or the knowledge. It depends largely on the people who are shaping that reality or creating that truth. Okay, now this is the second belief. And the third belief is there are one or maybe many realities. So there both possibilities are there. Okay, so this is the third famous concept of ontology. So keep in mind these three concepts. So we'll use them to form our research philosophy. Okay, now the first concept is that there is only one reality. The second concept is the realities are more than one. There is more than one realities, and it is not independent of perceiver. And finally, there is a belief that there is a one or maybe many realities exist. Okay, now this is ontological belief. Let's move to the second concept, which maybe we should understand very clearly or more clearly. It is epistemology. Now epistemology tells you about how we receive knowledge, how do we know about truth, how do we know about reality. It means that it tells us how we receive or how we collect knowledge. Okay, so this is epistemology. Similarly, like ontology, there are a lot of beliefs or ontological beliefs are available in the research or in the philosophy. But here in this video, to make it very simple, I'm just taking only three beliefs of the only three famous beliefs of epistemology. The first belief is that the knowledge can be measured, and it can be measured using any reliable tools and techniques. So there is a measurability in the truth or in the knowledge. That is the first belief. There is another belief that knowledge can be interpreted. It is not measurable, so you have to interpret it. That is the second belief of epistemology. So we can receive knowledge, or we can collect knowledge by interpreting any situation or any truth or any reality. Okay. Now the third belief is that the truth can be measurable, or knowledge can be measurable, or at the same time it can be explained or it can be interpreted. So this is the third belief or epistemological stance we are studying in this video. Okay. Now let's see how these concepts, they shape your research philosophy or the approach you are using in your thesis or in your final year project or in your any research you are planning to perform. Okay, now for example, in this equation you can see ontological beliefs and epistemological beliefs, they shape your research philosophy. Here I am taking the first belief, that the belief, ontological belief, is that there is only one reality and it can be measurable. So if we are using these two concepts, the philosophical approach we are going to see would be the positivism. So we are using positivism, and the positivism believes that there is one solution to a particular problem and it can be measurable. The knowledge is one, the reality is one, the truth is one, and it is measurable with the help of tools and techniques we can apply. So it depends on more quantitatively measuring the different beliefs and the knowledge. So knowledge is measurable, there is only one reality available and we can measure it using reliable tools and techniques. So this is positivism. Now let's see the second ontological belief, that is very simple. The truths are many, the realities are not only one, they are many, and it can be interpreted. It is not measurable, but rather than measuring them, we can interpret them and or explain them. So the interpretation and measurability with the help of this epistemological approach and the ontological approach is that there are multiple realities. We see this is constructivism. So in the constructivism, we consider that there are many realities and they can be interpreted or explained. Okay, so this is a philosophical approach where we mostly use our qualitative research. And then we have the third belief, the belief that the reality can be one and many, and the epistemological approach that it can be examined or it can be interpreted, means that it can be measured or it can be interpreted, both options are available, but we can use whatever the best tool available for the situation, and that is epistemological approach. And in that case we are using a pragmatism approach. So pragmatic approach or pragmatism research philosophy deals with the situation where ontological belief is that the reality can be one and many, and it can be, the knowledge can be measured and also it can be interpreted. So this is pragmatism in terms of research philosophy. These are the three major approaches of research methodology. So let's just conclude these, how these three different techniques or different philosophies are being formed from epistemological and ontological beliefs. But here I want to mention that when we are starting our research, it is very important for us to understand what is our strength, whether we are going for positivism, whether we are going for constructivism, or we are going for pragmatism, means that we are going for quantitative, qualitative, or mixed method or multi-method research. Okay. Now let's just conclude what we learned from this video in this situation. Ontological stance is basically depending on the three major beliefs that I use in this video, the singular reality, multiple realities, and singular or multiple realities. Okay. And then epistemological beliefs I use, it can be measured, the knowledge can be measured using sophisticated tools or scientific rules. And then epistemological stance is that the second epistemological stance is that reality can be interpreted. It is not measurable, instead it is interpretable. And finally, the third is basically we can use either measurement or we can interpret the reality, whatever best fit in the situation we are in, we can use all this. Okay, so this is how we form different research philosophies. The positivism is based on ontological stance of singularity, means that there is only one truth and it can be, and the knowledge can be measured. So we are using two tools to measure that, that is positivism. And in second, we conclude the constructivism as an approach where we believe that there are multiple realities and the truth or the knowledge needs to be interpreted. And finally, we have pragmatism, which believes that ontological approach is by whether reality is singular or it can be multiple, and we can use any available tool to measure it or we can interpret it. That is called pragmatism. So I hope so you understand these concepts. What you need to do is in the comment box you have to mention that what is your approach in your research, finally a project thesis or in your research article. I hope so this video will be useful for you to understand the research philosophies. Thank you very much and have a very nice day.